Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam did it. He made his wives smile and blush and laugh as well. Subhanallah. Obviously within the limits, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He was as romantic as could be, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. There was an incident when he was eating a piece of meat, and Aisha radiallahu anha picked up this piece of meat and bit from it, and he looked at her from the corner of his eye, and he watched that she was watching him. So he picked up the piece of meat and he turned it around to find the place that she bit from, and looking at her with the corner of his eye, he then bit from exactly the same place, making her blush. Subhanallah. With us, if the wife has bitten, we will say, if I bite, I'm going to get the cough you have. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Imagine to drink from a cup at exactly the same position that your wife drank from is a sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Why do we have to wait for the month of Ramadan to hear this type of thing? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us understanding and protection. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam has taught us a lot, and this is why he says, look, be careful of your tongues. You can utter good words or bad words. Say for example, there is something that you notice within the marriage. You need to talk. Communication is the most important thing in marriage. A lot of women folk, very sadly, they are upset. Suddenly it takes 3 weeks to find out why they were upset. And then we will find out it was something that really was not even worth mentioning. And this is why advice to everyone in this verse, speak that which is upright. Speak up when you have to speak. Because when you are silent, when you have to speak, it is also against the etiquettes of marriage. And a happy home will not be achieved. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant that to us. You need to talk. You have a problem, speak, but in good words. If you are sick, say that, look, I'm not well, that's why I'm not smiling. A husband comes to the home after a long day at work and he sees a woman cross. Wallahi, it puts his heart really on a different note, very low note. He feels like leaving the house once again. But a woman, to be honest with you, controls the love that a man has for her in almost all cases. Because when a woman pampers the man and looks after him and smiles at him and waits for him and is prepared to cook for him and really do everything for him, naturally, even if he likes it or not, at some stage he will feel an inclination towards this woman. And this is why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he distributed his wealth and his time perfectly, he then says, Allahumma hadha qasami fima amlik fala tu'akhidhni fima la amlik. Oh Allah, I've distributed that which I control between my wives. I am being just amongst them. So now don't hold against me what I do not control. And that is how much I love them. They control it. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. He said clearly, I love Aisha more than the rest. Fadlu Aisha ka fadli tharidi ala sa'ir ta'am. He says, Aisha, the virtue of her above all the other women is like the virtue of the favorite food above the rest of the food. When you see the favorite food, mashallah, you will first take it close to you. And you will first eat from it. Allahu Akbar. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam has instructed us. And the instruction is for all of us to ensure that we are just with our wives. And at the same time, we realize and understand that the love generally, if a man is a normal man, then how much he loves his wife will mainly depend on what she does for him or what she does not do. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make our wives from amongst those who can serve us. The Western world is teaching us that the wife doesn't need to serve the husband. And that is why you find the husband then looks outside the doors in order to look for someone whom he will get attention from. Someone who might cook for him, because the wife says you must bring takeaways. Takeaways are good once in a while. Some people are marrying on condition that the husband brings takeaways on a daily basis. Or you must take me out every Saturday, I won't cook. If that is the case, yes, he might do it for us with his wealth, but you lose his love. Allahu Akbar. The heavier you are on his pocket, the less he will love you. It is a fact, it is natural, and it happens. The more demanding you are, the less he loves you. He will go for someone else. And who would have caused that? Yourself with your own actions. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us protection. Many men who look outside, many times, the woman is to blame, but it's difficult for us to tell her. Because sometimes she cannot discuss the topics of what is going on behind the scenes. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us understanding. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that is why He tells us how important communication is in marriage. Let me quickly go through some of the most important items that will make a home extremely happy. If you would like a happy home and a happy marriage, you need to spend time with one another. You need to spend time with your wife and your children and your family members. You need to be tolerant of one another. You need to tolerate the differences that you have and speak. You need to trust one another completely. Don't pry into each other's little corners and cubicles. May Allah protect us. And at the same time, don't give your spouse the reason to doubt you. But don't ever doubt your spouse unnecessarily just by an anonymous phone call or something. Because that is a cancer. It will lead to divorce. And believe me, at times people are just mischief makers. All marriages go through turbulence. Let's understand and realize that if we are going to trust our spouses and give them a chance and tolerate and so on, inshallah, we will be able to deal with our crises. Another very interesting point, to be tender and lenient, to be calm and polite, that is also a very, very interesting point that we need to take or bear in mind if we'd like our marriages to work. A person who is hard and harsh, or a female who is hard and harsh in the way she talks, others will turn away from them according to the Quran. وَلَوْ كُنْتَ فَضًّا غَلِيظَ الْقَلْبِ لَنْ فَضُّوا مِنْ حَوْلِكَ. O Prophet of Allah, if you were hard-hearted and if you were harsh, they would have dispersed from you. If that instruction was for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what about us with our own spouses? They will disperse from us if we are hard and heavy. They will not like us. Their love for us will be reduced. So let us learn to speak in a very polite manner with sweet words. You have to beautify your voice when you are speaking to your spouse. Why do we tend to do that when we are speaking to others besides our spouses, whom we are not even supposed to be talking to in the first place? Won't that then result in some form of negativity in the hearts of our spouses when they say, our husband is good to all the women on earth, but not to us? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. A person who is excellent to other women on the street, 9 times out of 10 when he comes home, they fear him. Allahu Akbar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. We need to be normal outside. You don't have to be overly excellent. Normal outside, but at your home or within the house, you need to be overly excellent, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us politeness. Another very interesting point is, we need to realize marriage is all about sacrifice. If you are not prepared to sacrifice, then your marriage will probably not work. It will be void of love. You need to sacrifice your time, your effort, your money, your brains, your mind. Everything needs to be sacrificed. And there is no room for laziness in marriage. Many people are in love and then suddenly they get married. And then the wife doesn't even know how to cook. May Allah protect us. And she sleeps until 11 in the morning. If that is the case, he will get lazy and he will get fed up and he won't. Or the love in his heart for you will begin to diminish very soon. Because there are other women who get up at 5 in the morning and make a hot cup of tea with a little bit of breakfast and bring it to bed. May Allah protect us all. I'm not encouraging, promoting or demoting any breakfasts in bed. But at the same time, we are saying that we need to think of this. Don't be lazy. Look after the children and you will earn the love of your husband, inshallah. At the same time, spoil him rotten and inshallah, you will protect yourself from being rotten, inshallah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us of how important it is to sacrifice in marriage, to be thankful and grateful for what your spouse has done for you. If your wife is looking after your children and is cooking for you and so on, think about it for a moment. How much time and effort does she spend behind you? And at the same time, when the husband is spending so many hours earning a livelihood in order to bring back a plate of food on the table, thank him at times. Say, I thank you. I appreciate it. Wallahi, you've done so much for me. I really, really appreciate this. And show it in every single way. Thankfulness is part and parcel of rekindling your marriage, inshallah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us how important expressions on your face are. Always have a smile. Always try to be happy. Always show good expressions. You know, a wink or two is also quite romantic at times between husband and wife. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us use our expressions where they are most beneficial and not where they are detrimental. Outside the home, mashallah, we have a smile stuck on our faces. As soon as we come home, we are frowning like we've never ever frowned before. Remember, even if you'd like to age slowly, why I say slowly is because we have to age. If Allah gives us life, we have to age. But if you'd like to age slowly, learn to smile. Believe me, you will not age as quickly as those who frown. When you frown, your forehead has a mark. And that mark will become really engraved into your forehead. Even when you are happy, they will still see that mark. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. So it's a reality. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also tells us that we need to have an understanding between one another. You need to draw your limits and your lines. Say what